navigation menu with the hover and shadow drops. Hello, this guys is basically I created with is from HTML5 and HTML5 and CSS transition properties. It's too easy to create, guys, from just its basics. For those who don't know anything about HTML5, they can do it. It's the most easiest way. I just created this in Dreamweaver. I just started a project. So I used this navigation menu to set up it. So just guys, we just close here. We just go in Dreamweaver and just to create a new document. So just going to create. So guys, I'm basically using Adobe Dreamweaver CC. You can use CS6 because the transition property works in it. You can create everything, but it's consist of it. So just guys, let's start with it, and we just create going to our code view, and we done yet. So here our basic HTML is. I'm just going to write in this body tag. We just going to write OEH. Sorry guys, we're just going to open a div first. Div and space, which is give it ID, and ID equals to what we tell is nav. So nav stands for navigation menu. It's basically, guys, just we are creating a basic HTML. First A space H reference. Just guys, this will link our, which will create our text to linking F. Sorry guys, you just give it a hash and just look close it is. And right here, what you basically need is that I'm writing a tutorial, TUTURAL tutorial. So just go done here. I'm just going to, so wait a minute guys, let me check that. Now it's correct. Sorry guys, now it's incorrect. Now it's correct, guys. Now basically I'm going to do it with copying this. See, and just sorry guys, wait a minute. I'm just going to paste it thrice, 1, 2, 3, and just go to tutorials and Dreamweaver, G-R-E-A-M-W-E-R, Dreamweaver. Sorry guys, all I want in capitals, so G-R-E-A-M-W-E-R. And another thing, Dreamweaver plus, we just need another thing, what is in take, I'll just take us gallery, gallery. As I preview in browser, as I save it first, just go to techno.tut. Guys, this is my first page. I created that to show you, and I'm going to take index1.html. So just I'm going to save it and just going to preview to you. Just preview in browser, F12 hard key. So guys, this is it. What we looks like. It doesn't looks anything attractive. Just a bit, guys. Now just to create our CSS. So guys, for creating the CSS, you must use the another style sheet and just write in that and link to it. But this is a project. For this tutorial, I'm going to show you in writing this only. So first of all, we're just going to give hash. Sorry, first open style type. Style type equals to text slash CSS. Just done yet, and just end of style, which let it begin, guys. For our CSS, just first we just reset it. So reset property is the basics. So reset property, which give it a margin to margin equals to 0 pixels. Sorry guys, margin equals to 0 pixels, and sorry, there's an equals to, guys, and just it margin colon semi pixels. And padding to colon 0 pixels. Just yet, guys, just done it. We just reset our things just as a preview in browser there. So sorry guys, you can check this out. All the borders, margins and paddings have been released. So it's a reset, that's why it's called a reset property here. Now we just give another thing is, now we just open div nav, nav hash nav, because it's an ID. So for class you must write dot nav and just write float to left, position to relative, and then yeah, just save that. as you can see, as you can give it a margin too, just give it a margin, margin hyphen top. From top we need the margin to 20 pixels, and from margin hyphen left we need 10 pixels. We just done yet, guys, for this property. As I show you this here, guys, you can see it's now titled. Now we just go and open a tag. So just go in there and hash nav space a. Just we are done yet, and just we get a font hyphen family. I'm using elephant, I think it's free for free to download. You can download and just apply to it. I'm using it, or I'm going to give you a link in the description if you use that. So guys, basically use your own fonts. So Ella, I'm using it, and just refresh. This is a font family Ella, and we just want to be font size different, font hyphen size, font size. Sorry guys, wait a minute. Font size to colon to 18 pixels, just the font size, so just 18 pixels, and font color color, font, just give it a color. What we give the color is, select the color, just give it a dark gray, hash 330 for the code. And for another things, we just first preview in our browser. Just refresh it, guys. This is it. We're here. So, and you can see in the browser that it have the underlines, and we don't need the underlines, guys. But sorry, to remove it, just write text hyphen decoration. Text decoration, set it to none, so no underlines will be previewed. Just I just review. Let's go in design view and just leave live here, guys. As you can see, this is elephant. Go to split and you're going to code view. Let me preview in the browser. Yes guys, see this, this is removed now, the underlines is removed. So we just give it another tag first, guys. After applying the text decoration, we can see that there is no link hover. As we hover that mouse button, it do not mix any color changes different, so that's what we needed it. And just give it a padding to all the padding from 18 pixels by 24 pixels space, guys, 18 pixels by 24 pixels, and just semicolon there and enter. Just go, so you can, I just refresh and just preview in my browser that there's some guys, see this, we just covered nice little space between them. So just applying now, we just want to apply and hover first. So guys, first we're going to transition property there, transition. So write transition colon, sorry, wait a minute guys, let me check my spelling first. Just write the transition all space 0.5 seconds space and ease all with ease, just space colon, and just come down and make our hover. So just to make a hover, write the hash nav space a colon hover hover, and just open close parentheses, guys. Now just to do that, we just want to make sure what we want to change in. So we just wanted to make a drop shadow. So to make a drop shadow, we need the text shadow code. It's in the Dreamweaver. It's most successful in HTML5 because it looks nice. So write in text text hyphen shadow. So you got that, just colon, and for 10 pixels from top left right and top bottom to 10 pixels, and just for blurry we need 4 pixels, just give it 3 pixel blur, and just write a color of hash and just make it a light gray. So as you can see now, just refresh and just make sure you preview in browser here, refresh, and just guys, this is you created. So guys, but we have one thing that it's in this, it's hover too, so it's come, the letters comes up, so it looks nice, but in this only the shadows drop down, nothing happening here. So for that guys, we have to apply for our property there, transform transition property. For a few tips I'm gonna make use is that you must write in this display block and just also give it a float left, so it will work, and this is okay. So just cars to make you feel better, and we're just going to take and design, you said this, so we just want it in this three boxes we just required yet done yet. So just we give in the CSS transition property box. If you don't have that, just go to window, click on CSS transition. So just click there and just I got a CSS transition box there. So hash nav hover three instance you can get there. We just have a text shadow we're just gonna add here, just gonna add here, which are going to transform it. Go to click on transform, give this a scale, scale to 1.3, save transition there, and just click on the live view there. So guys, this is it, we have successfully created that, and just for the view you can see that, and there's a background the shadow, it's getting too blurry guys, so we just go to code view and just take look at our CSS property there. So we just go here and make 3 pixels to get to 1.5 pixels guys. So just refresh and just go to preview in browser there. So preview in browser, just guys, this is it, we successfully created it. And if you want to grow it bigger guys, just change this value property, so that you successfully created it. If you like this tutorial, I'm going to create many like that. So if you like, please subscribe and just get the tutorials and start creating yours. And if you have any doubt, please don't feel shy and just write it in description, and that's it. Today's for that's it, and just we here.